You like that?
Finger looking good.
Finger looking good. All right. Like a stir fry, whip it in the kitchen, wrist twist it like a stir fry,
whip it in the kitchen, wrist twist it like a stir fry. Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. My name is Raven, and today I will be showing all of you how I make my low carb stir fry. It is amazing. Y'all, this recipe is to die for if you're just starting off with your keto journey, if you're starting low carb period, or you're dieting and you just want something good and not high in calories and carbs. Try this meal, it's delicious. So let's go ahead and get right into it.
In this video, I'll be using smoked sausage, zucchini, squash, olive oil, shrimp, string beans, and of course use whatever seasoning you prefer. So right here, you're just gonna see me prepping my pans, getting everything together, putting olive oil and butter in them for the shrimp and for the vegetables. So I'm gonna start cooking here. Whatever seasoning or flavoring you like to add to your shrimp, now's the time to do so. I love my garlic and herb seasoning and my Lawry seasoning salt, so you'll see me cooking with those quite often. Those are my favorite. Just gonna cook the shrimp and stir it up, and go ahead and get this squash chopped up and get ready to put that inside that pan over there with that oil. We're gonna get our stir fry cooking here. Doesn't take long at all, guys. Probably 20 minutes tops. I just went on and sped that up a little bit for y'all. It's basically simple. I'm cutting up the squash and zucchini, about to add it to the pot. Be careful not to have your grease too hot like I did just now. I obviously probably had it on 10, being forgetful sometimes, I can do that. But just have your oil on about 7. You need it about medium high to cook and just simmer down. So you don't have to have it that high, just medium high. And you just want to stir up the zucchini and the squash just to make sure that it's cooking on all sides. Making sure that grease is hitting it and it's starting to cook down. You can start to see it brown a little bit in some spots. That's how we want it before we go ahead and start adding string beans. Now you can chop yours up or you can cut them whole. You're going to see I've just chopped up some of them, and then the rest of them I'm going to just add in there whole because I love for majority of them to be whole inside my pot. I promise it's not a lazy thing, it's a preference thing. I don't know why I prefer for the string beans to stay long, but to be honest, y'all, this is my first meal that I use fresh string beans with. I'm used to string beans in a can, but I love these fresh string beans, and I prefer for them to be whole like that. I'm just, you know, weird that way, I guess. And then I added more seasoning to the pot after I added the string beans, of course. And then now you just see me chopping up my sausages. I'm gonna go ahead and put those in the oven, let them cook on about 350 degrees until those brown. Checking on my stir fry here some more, and just of course now we're just gonna cook this down, let it simmer.
Alright, so everything's been cooking good. I think it's about time for us to check up on our sausage. Oh, looks perfect. It's ready, so I'm about to go ahead and take that out.
You just want the sausage to cook down some. You don't have to have it burnt. Doesn't have to be crispy. See, mine just look a little golden around the edges there. That's perfect for me. You can just let it cook that like that, and that's fine. Now it's time to add that sausage to the pot with our stir fry. Get that stirred up going here a little bit. This is starting to get the consistency that I loved my stir fry to have. I love for it to be kind of soupy, not dry. I'm gonna add my seasoning, of course. Y'all, you're gonna see I add seasoning about 3 or 4 times throughout this whole process. Like, basically after I add more to the pot, I season it some more. And this pot that I'm cooking with does not have a top that comes with it, so I just had to add a little pot just to steam that a little bit here, y'all. You see me do a little get and miss, it's okay. Because I'm getting the consistency that I want with my stir fry. That right there is perfect. And thanks for watching, y'all. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I will be making more videos, so again, comment and tell me what you want to see. Thank you for watching. Like y'all didn't think that I could bump like this. Said I told y'all I was going